Hey guys, welcome back. Hey guys, welcome back to another video. Today, we're not actually going to be working on the Evo or anything, but we're here to pick up a new car for this lovely lady. So we traded the Outlander. Oh no, we actually sold the Outlander, and we actually are picking our new ride up. Mine or yours?
Mine.
Hers. Is it a bit fair that your car costs way more than mine?
Yes.
Apparently, twice as much. Let's go check it out. What are you waiting for, love? New ride. Is that behind you? Have a look behind you. Not that one? Are you excited to see a new car? Mm-hmm. Yes? No? Maybe?
Around this side here, we do have the refueler. Car has to be unlocked for you to refuel the vehicle, okay? Diesel tank, AdBlue. Have you ever dealt with AdBlue before? Okay, so AdBlue is this little one here, okay? So basically that is a clearing agent for the vehicle. So I've got to make this work. Just what you put under it, so if you've got all your shopping, you'll be able to open that straight up. Depending on your garage or your height, you can adjust this, right? So if you need to bring it down to, say, that height, just hold your finger there. There is a little dull beep there.
Yep.
There it goes, and we'll set it at that, okay? In the back here, we've got all of our tools through here. This one will open up. Click in there, all the tools. And the jack is all here. Then the seats left and right, so just press the button here and they'll come up. Left one and the right one.
Beautiful.
The windows are here, pretty self-explanatory those ones, they're all auto ones. Left and right hand for the door mirrors, up, down, side to side. This one will manually fold the mirrors in. So if I was sort of going through that tight doorway there, I'd manually fold those ones in. And this one is for the memory for the kids, so they don't play with the things up and down. It's memories for the seats, 1, 2, and 3. You can code those to the key. So if you've got one, you can set yours as number one, keep the second key away from it, and then come over, swap over, program the second one, get the second key, unlock, lock, and we'll code the second key to it.
Okay.
All right. Here is for the lights. So there's obviously the off position. Whichever one we go to, it'll always go back to the auto. So they'll give you the halo lights at the front, automatic high beam, or always be on. The front driving lights, your rear fog lamp. This will do the lightness and the brightness of the dash in here. Okay. And then you've got your boot release. Okay. With the boot release, you have to be in park or neutral, handbrake on, to open the door. Otherwise, when you go to the shopping centre, everyone will open the boot and you're driving off, all your shopping falls out the back, right? And all the safety aspect of kids being in the back, getting their bags out. For our main cluster here, this one here, hold to reset any of the buttons or reset any of the computer systems that are in it. Okay, we have our rev counter, the transmission, kilometers this side, coolant, temperature of the gearbox, bar of the turbo, the pressure in there, and the distance to empty. So at the moment, the way we're driving, 717 k's before we drive. I'll run out of fuel. The one push talks to the car. Triple M.
Which one would you like?
One.
Tuning to triple M.
And I'll give you FM or the digital one for it. Okay. If you ask for 2GB, it's gonna say playing 2GB. That's just the way it's programmed with it. Having gone overboard with it, you can put speed limit assistance with it. If you've got the cruise control on, it'll go 60, 80, 100, all the way through it. Saying that, it's sometimes if there's double signs in a school zone, because they're not worldwide
recognized
yeah. ones, it could add to
your speed.
Yeah. Right, so just be mindful of that. The pre-collision assistance is on the vehicle.
Mm-hmm.
That's what that little blue button out the front there is for, just looking for hazards all the time for it. The BLIS is your blind spot information system to it. Cross traffic alert, it doesn't allow you to pull out in front of anybody if it thinks it's danger, and so too reverse brake assistance.
So these are warning signals?
It is warning signals and it will jam the brakes.
Okay.
Vehicle timer countdown, if you leave the vehicle unattended after 30 minutes it will turn itself off. The rear occupant alert, when you turn the vehicle off, it's going to bing 5 times with a picture of the baby seat in the back to tell you to remove all the occupants. There's a lot of the things going on through here, but basically remote setup is set at 10 minutes. We can adjust that to 15 minutes to cool it all down. And the seats and steering wheel is in auto. All right, so if it's below a certain degrees, it's going to warm the both front seats up, warm the steering wheel up for you. The mirrors are on automatic fold when they've done. Lighting set for 20 seconds. The boot power lid is all on for you. Advanced mode, that's when you're really comfortable with the vehicle. You can say, call John at MacArthur Ford, and it'll just do it straight away without even prompting you to do anything. The zone lighting, I turned that on previously, it's turned off, but we can activate that by your phone and we can light up the front, the side, the rear of the vehicle. Our buttons here, we can use them all through here, or we hit the up button here and we can say we want the air conditioning on that and take control of it, turn it off or on. Okay. Fan speeds here, max here, so that'll warm your feet up quickly as possible, warm the screen up. This max here will cool the car down as quickly as possible. Okay. As again, your remote start it, it'll do all this before you even get back to the vehicle. Okay. This button here, so this one's for your heated steering wheel at the top. This one's for your cooled seats, this one's for your warm seats. Okay. So car's not running, but once the car runs, you've got high, medium, low, and then off with it. Okay. And this one here is for the rear air conditioning. Okay. So front air conditioning, get the rear. The rear's locked at the moment, so the kids can't play with it. But yeah, just unlock that. Well, that's locking in, I should say. That stops them from using
that's
it,
good,
so they'll get whatever the driver's getting. Okay. But if you need to adjust it here, fan speed, you can just adjust it here. Okay.
So pretty much this does what this does too.
Basically, yes. Yep.
It just saves you from, like, you know, touching the screen if you're driving.
When you're driving, correct, yeah. Automated parking system, okay? So you can navigate one to a park, we can ask for parking assistance, okay? So we can parallel park in between any of these vehicles going this way, but we can also park in between these ones as well now. And if you get really stuck, hit this button here, choose which side you're gonna indicate from, and it'll help you get you out. Do all the parking, do all the hard stuff for you, wherever you hold your finger on this button.
Okay.
Okay. As soon as you release that button, touch the steering wheel, touch the brake, touch the accelerator, all cancels it. Your control, traction control, your automatic stop start feature. This one here again brings up our front camera. Okay. Just another quick shortcut through to it. Now, this is our four-wheel drive mode. So we're in two-wheel high at the moment. Now we've got our drive modes. We keep an eye on the screen there. We're in normal mode. We give it a twist to you. Takes us into eco mode. So we're driving from here to Queensland, more fuel efficient. All right, you can see it's got a bit of a green hue to it. We then go from there to tow haul mode. It automatically puts it into four auto. Okay. And gives us a yellow hue to it. We then go from there to slippery mode. All right, it's still in four auto. We then go into mud and rut modes. Okay, It then puts it back into 4x4, it locks the rear diff in, mm-hmm. and brings our camera up so we can navigate off-road.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And then we've got one more, which is the sand mode. Again, just changes itself, tells you that the rear diff is locked into the vehicle, and where all the power is going, and that's all the modes in it.
Okay.
So then we just, all the way back to the left hand side,
normal.
Take it back into normal, okay. sort of take it out of 4 high,
mm-hmm.
into 4 auto.
Okay.
Okay. Weather like today, probably best driving around in 4 auto, give you most traction and everything for that. When it's all nice and dry, you just do a normal driving, you can just put it in 2 high,
mm-hmm.
that'll save you fuel,
okay.
tyres, transmission, all that
okay,
stuff.
Okay, so like everyday normal when you start?
Everyday normal good. There.
Okay.
Just, yeah, it's a big car, gets right into a roundabout, it hasn't rained for a while, you might slip out and all that.
Okay.
This will keep it in all wheel drive for
okay.
you. Yeah. Press this back, it's for the sunroof.
Mm-hmm.
That's just your deflector
mm-hmm.
there to stop the wind gulping straight in.
Mm-hmm.
We hit back mode, we close it for us, and we push that to the front, and that brings the venting mode. So you can just suck all the hot air out.
Okay.
Yep. Locks it for us. And then this one here is the blind.
Oh,
okay.
Okay.
So
the kids are gonna love this.
So
yeah. So days like today, all good, middle of summer, gets a bit hot. Yep, just press that. We'll come back up to halfway. And then
so it doesn't fully close?
Yep.
It will.
It will.
Yep. And then the second push will fully close.
Okay. Awesome.
Yep. Alright. Ambient lighting.
Yep.
So it's on. Boom. And then you just put your
brightness. Yeah.
Brightness. Yep.
Yeah. And so that stays on whenever the headlights.
That'll stay on all the time.
Yeah. Okay.
Anytime that it will dim down, same as your zone lighting, as if the car notices that's going to drop in voltage.
Okay.
Okay. And it will come off. But yeah, emergency assistance is on there. So if you're unfortunate enough to have an accident in the vehicle, it'll dial police, fire, ambulance, send it to your GPS location. Unless you reply back to the vehicle, I'm okay. It'll keep an open line with you and emergency services for it. There's your Ford dealer there. Type in where you want to go or one push, yeah, find a Ford dealership. I need a coffee, anything we need to do. All right, search for fuel pricing and I'll search for the relevant ones all the way around you.
Oh, it
okay.
actually tells you the prices?
Yes.
Wow.
Yes. When you get closer to them, it does tell you all the prices. And this is the price for diesel. All right? So yeah.
Make sure you pull diesel, okay?
Yeah, make sure it's diesel. Yeah. All right. Go to inter-vehicle maintenance.
Mm-hmm.
There's your tyre pressures, tyre pressure monitors, engine information, your engine oil life, your AdBlue info.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? The level is okay.
Mm-hmm.
We go back.
Can we have a you know, you can customize the cluster? Can you have the AdBlue as a one of the features up there?
Let's have a look. Selectable, light selectable. There you go. Bang! It's there. Second one.
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay. Perfect.
Yep. So place the transmission, but unless you go four-wheel driving, you wouldn't need to know what the transmission
okay.
temperature is.
Yeah, right. Correct.
If you plan to go four-wheel driving, let me know.
That can be easily changed.
It could be,
yeah.
Don't need to touch anything.
Does it ever make mistakes?
Not that I've been in with, no.
And you're holding the P down.
Yeah.
Yes.
You have to.
And if you take it off,
it's going to stop.
And it's close. Put it back in the park for you. All done.
That is so cool.
Yeah. But, Google.
Keep an eye out for.
Yeah,
it says,
and then it says now you can take control. So back in the drive and away we go.
Is that too high? You're is as high as I can go, man.
Oh gosh.
The steering wheel's really low.
Is it low? Yeah. Following what John was telling you?
No.
There's a lever right there.
This one?
Push it down.
Yep. Pull up and up if you want to take it out. Yep, now lock it. Life's hard. Now you gotta press a button in this. Stop button. Stop button. On the right hand side. You gotta have your leg on the brake too.
I haven't had lunch. I haven't had lunch, man.
Oh gosh.
Can you edit me out of
this? No, this is the best part. Oh my gosh. Okay.
So,
you're gonna drop this now. There's a button at the top, the front. Yep, press and we gotta put it into D. You press it again to open the wall. Alright, mate. Leave. First time on the road. How does it feel? No words, yeah? The sound's pretty good. Hey guys, so it's the second day. We picked it up yesterday. It was raining, pouring down yesterday, so I couldn't really come home and actually make any videos after we picked it up. So far, we love the car. It's amazing. I think mod-wise, I might go for some bigger wheels. Not actually bigger, but just bigger tires and some more aggressive offset wheels. So these in the Platinum come with the 21-inch, but yeah, they a bit sunken in. So I'll see when I have some time. I might go chuck some new rims and some new tyres on. Some more all-terrain tyres. I don't think it's going to be going anywhere in the bush. Maybe sand, that's about it. Oh, and by the way, we did replace the rotors in the Evo, and I finally got it all painted, the front. In the rear, I've taken the red Volt T37 stickers off because obviously it was clashing with all the colors going on, but yeah, so I got some new stickers on as well, a little bit different. See how I like it. Yeah, so that's it. Well guys, thanks for tuning in and we will see you in the next episode
from YouTube Daddy Kiki.
Make sure you like, share and
care.
Subscribe. Ha ha ha. Bye.